Naval Reserve is an essential part of the Canadian Navy. It plays several key roles in the maritime defense of Canada. Its 4,000 reservists undergo a high level of general and specialized training. They can be employed on either a part-time or full-time basis. There are 24 Naval Reserve divisions based in communities across Canada where reservists train throughout the year. Reservists also provide crews for our fleet of 12 Maritime Coastal Defense Vessels, or MCDVs, based on both coasts. There is also a state-of-the-art training facility at Naval Reserve Headquarters in Quebec City. Weekly training gives way to more intensive full-time periods during the summer months. This accommodates the high school, college, and university students who make up the majority of the reserve.
It's not just a summer job. You do make a lot of money during the summer, and it's awesome that you pretty much have a guaranteed summer job, which is great for students, but it's a lot more than just that. Mm-hmm. The people that you meet in the Naval Reserve are awesome.
It's definitely, for a student, the number one job that any student can have, for sure.
Cruise ship numbers 204 continues to draw left, sir.
Candidates can join the reserves and qualify as officers or as non-commissioned members. Officers are trained to navigate and command ships, to work in intelligence, or in logistics. There are also opportunities for chaplains, musical directors, and public affairs officers. Non-commissioned members can be trained in naval communications, combat information systems, marine engineering, resource and supply management, diving, music, or cooking.
When you join the Navy as a cook, you don't need to know anything about cooking. They teach you everything from the very basics of, like, how to fry eggs right up to a rack of lamb.
General training is common to all and includes damage control, rescue, and weapons handling.
Everybody is a sailor first. You have to be able to handle lines. You have to be prepared in the event of any emergencies to fight a fire or flood, to assist with casualty clearing, to assist with recovering a man overboard, etc. These are things that everybody has to know how to do, and then your job kind of comes second to that.
There are also opportunities to serve in the regular Navy, either ashore or at sea, including in operational areas. Reservists have in the past fulfilled 6-month tours in major warships in Middle Eastern waters, the Mediterranean, the Pacific, and the North Atlantic. The Naval Reserve has an important job. Patrolling our coastal waters maintains Canadian sovereignty, upholds Canadian laws, and protects Canadian resources and the environment. The MCDVs are modern, well-equipped ships of 800 tons. Their missions include conducting surveillance of our coastline and mine countermeasures. This remotely operated vehicle, or ROV, can investigate objects on the sea floor as deep as 6,000 feet below the surface. It has twin manipulator arms and several onboard cameras. MCDVs are at sea year-round. As well as patrolling Canadian coastlines, fishing grounds, and oil fields, they often voyage as far afield as the Baltic and Hawaii to exercise with Allied forces. The contractual obligations of reservists are more flexible than those of their regular force counterparts. To a certain degree, reservists can choose the training and periods of service that suit them best.
The Naval Reserve is very flexible with that. They understand that school is your number one priority and that Naval Reserves doesn't necessarily come first. However, they really encourage you to participate as much as possible.
The Naval Reserve works around your schedule in school or if you have another part-time job. We only work Tuesdays, Thursdays, and one Saturday a month, so it's very flexible.
Reserve service can, in effect, be tailored to individual career goals. This strikes a productive balance between one's civilian and military lives.
It's really up to you what you really want to do and how much you want to accomplish and in what type of time frame.
During the academic year, most training takes place at the local Naval Reserve Division. A weekday evening is designated for these activities, which not only hones skills, but also provides an opportunity to meet friends and socialize.
You only come in a couple times a week. In my case, I usually just came in once a week on Wednesday nights. And honestly, it was a nice break to get away from the school stuff for a while and come socialize a little bit with the Navy crowd.
Morale is usually pretty good. I mean, you work hard, but then you play hard when you're off. And you build a really strong camaraderie with the people you go through your courses with.
There are occasional weekend training opportunities, too. Here, members of HMCS STAR in Hamilton, Ontario, conduct a harbor protection exercise.
There are times when I will take time away from school to go away on weekend training exercises, but it's always valuable because my training skills and expertise improve. So it's a matter of balancing between being a part-time Naval Reservist and a full-time student.
Reservists earn a good wage for the time they spend in uniform, an excellent supplement to student budgets, and a reimbursement program provides a tuition grant over and above their pay. For those on full-time duty, the benefits are generous and include free travel, food, accommodations, uniforms, medical and dental services, and paid vacation days. Skills learned in the Naval Reserve can often give someone the edge in the competitive civilian job market. Management skills, leadership, and being able to work as part of a team are the types of qualities employers recognize in reservists, to say nothing of technological skills.
It looks great on resume, and I said my people skills have increased tremendously, and it just helps me like follow timelines and guidelines.
When the time comes to leave the reserve, it is a simple and uncomplicated matter and may include a gratuity or pension, depending on an individual's length of service. The Naval Reserve offers both young and more mature Canadians a worthwhile second career, full or part-time, serving their country in important roles as an essential component of the Navy and the Canadian Forces. Think about it. Give it a go.